Hello everyone, thanks for joining to the talk. I am going to share a project that I have created months ago. The project is called Offensive Docker, and it is a Docker image with the more useful tools to create an offensive environment to use in a CTF, pen testing, or bug bounty. Who I am? I am Husband of Dad. I have a 1-year-old baby, and together with my wife, they motivated me to create this type of project. All the projects require dedication, time to research, test, and other, and it's important the family support to get them. I have more than 10 years of experience in cybersecurity fields, being my expertise on identity and access management. I have participated in different webinars talking about JSON Web Token standard and how to use it to protect APIs. Currently, I am immersed in offensive security. I am learning and practicing pen testing and web hacking. So I decided to practice this knowledge with bug bounty programs where we have real targets to exploit vulnerabilities. How the project was born. When I got into offensive security, I want to have a portable environment to use in different places: desktop, notebook, or virtual private server. So the first requirement was portability. I want to have something like a box and move it into the different environments with the less maintenance and update with the last version. Additionally, it should be configured easily and quickly in all environments used by me to launch security assessments. I was looking for a multi-platform that should work with Windows, Mac, or Linux. Doesn't matter the operating system that I am using. Therefore, if I develop it, install scripts, it should have a specific logic about operating system to work properly. So I began to research and analyze what technology can provide me portability and multi-platform. Then the next requirement was availability. If I create a new server or environment, it should be available in few minutes with all offensive tools to launch a security assessment against my targets easily and quickly. So I began with those requirements. They were specific needs for me. But after talking about the project with more people, I understood that they had the same needs. Then I decided to publish the project and share with the cybersecurity community. Finally, the desire to learn is never lacking in a project. I really want to learn about new technology, acquire more knowledge, and why not share it with the community. So this is what I am doing today. What is Docker? Before showing the project, it is important to have clear some concepts. Docker is a technology that allows users to easily deploy applications and make portable environment regardless of the operating system. I used that technology to make a portable environment multi-platform highly available. In such a way, I can create environments easily and quickly to launch security assessments. We can see in the next screen how to work Docker against virtualization. Virtualization allows to create different virtual machines and it uses hypervisor to interact between the physical and virtual machine. We can install different operating systems like Windows or Linux. For Linux, we have Kali, Parrot, Ubuntu, and others. If I want to move a virtual machine to another environment, I need to copy the full virtual machine. I didn't like it and I felt discomfort because I will always need to have stored
the virtual machine to move to other place.
So I used Docker because I can create an image with all offensive tools and programming language. An image is built with a Docker file and it has the definitions or a structure to build the image. Docker technology uses containers to run an image by Docker engine. One can create multiple containers based on the same image. I can make with a container machines from HackTheBox, with another container make machines from DragHackMe, and with another container make recon processes from MyBugBounty programs. By using an image, I can create multiple environments to make different processes, and I can use it in another server or share it with other people, so they can use it without install the tools to offensive tags. To clarify, Docker has two concepts, image and container. Image has the definition or structure and container when the image is running. What is offensive Docker? Leveraging all the benefits of Docker, I use Ubuntu as a base image and I installed CTF, pentesting, MyBugBounty tools, and I make a big image to cover different use cases. Currently, the image has more than 40 tools and programming languages. As you know, in different situations, we need to develop our scripts to analyze the targets. We have the next programming language: Go, Node.js, Python, PHP, and Ruby. And I have labeled the offensive tool as port scanning, recon, Git repositories, brute force, operating system enumeration, and others. So I have created an image with the more useful offensive tools to analyze different targets. You can see the link to GitHub repository. Use case. The first case I used like an offensive server. The second case is used like a proxy server. Finally, I can use it like a client for VPN connections. Offensive server. When the containers are running with all offensive tools, can be treated as a server. So I call it offensive server. As you can see in the image, I am showing all the offensive tools installed under the tools directory. Proxy server. In some cases, when we are analyzing targets from any programs, we can detect geographic restrictions. Then, we need to use a proxy server to bypass the restriction. Offensive Docker has installed a proxy server to use it. You can configure a browser or board suite with the proxy server and access to the targets. The main idea is that the browser, board suite, and offensive Docker become your best friend to analyze your targets. In the next video, first, I identify my public IP address assigned by Internet Service Provider. So, I enter to a cloud server with offensive Docker and I launch a new container. Inside the container, I start the proxy server and I monitor the logs to see the traffic. At the left side, I query my public IP address again using the proxy and it shows other IP address. So I can launch my security assessment to avoid geographic restrictions. Client for VPN connections. If we practice on platforms like HackTheBox, DragHackMe, or use a specific VPN provider to avoid geographic restrictions, we need to launch a VPN connection to connect to those platforms. Offensive Docker has installed a VPN client and it is ready to start up VPN connections. So I can run a container to hack the box and another container to try hack me. I don't have restrictions to run both containers at the same time. In the next video, first, I list my VPN profile and after that, I launch a new container. Inside the container, I change the current directory to a directory with the VPN profile and I start a VPN connection. If you can see, I am connecting to the HubDevOps platform. At the right side, I enter to the same container with another session and I launch Port Discovery to a machine. It takes a second. And it shows the results. Then I launch another port discovery to a different machine and it shows another results. So you can launch different assessments to HubDevOps machines or another platform using VPN connection. Running offensive Docker. In the next section, I will show you how to run the containers to cover specific functionalities, VPN connections, data persistence, expose services, and mount file systems. VPN connections. When I tried to launch a VPN connection inside the container, it didn't work. I did a bit of troubleshooting, search in different forums and identify specific necessary parameters to pass when the container is launched. If I don't run the container with the next parameters, VPN connections won't work. The parameters are required for the container to interact with the network interface. Data persistence. The data inside the container is lost when I delete the container. That is not a good idea for us. As cybersecurity professionals, we need to store all information about our targets. Docker has a parameter to mount a local directory from my server or computer with a directory inside the container. We can store all information in the directory inside the container, remove the container, and all information will be saved in our server or computer. We don't go to lose the information. Expose services. If we go to expose any services inside the container, there is a parameter to enable the access from outside of the container. If we don't pass the parameter, nobody can connect to the services. For instance, the parameter is useful if we want to launch a web server inside the container to provide any information. Mount file system. In some cases, we have some target with resources shared, and for easy access, we can create a local mount to access and work with the information shared. If we don't pass the parameter privilege, it shows an error and we can mount resources shared. Offensive Docker Custom. Offensive Docker has a set of tools with default configurations. But there are tools that require additional configurations to exploit all functionalities and get bad results. Due to this, a customization is required and I have worked in a process to achieve it. At this moment, this process worked for me, but I don't discard other options. You can see the link to GitHub repository. We go to see custom settings, process to follow, and example. Custom settings. Some tools require credentials like AP keys or tokens to retrieve more information from different sources. For instance, AMAS, Find Domain, or Subfinder can retrieve more subdomains in a scanning against a scanning with the file configuration. I told you that the data doesn't persist on the container, so all command history is lost when I delete a container,
And for us, the common history is important because if we forget an important common, we can search on the history. So I have identified the process to store and maintain the history common by a customization. Alias or function environment can help us to do our job quicker. A good tip is to generate an alias or function environment to work more comfortable when we launch the offensive tools. We can add them to the offensive Docker via customization. Process to follow. How did I resolve it? I started using offensive Docker as my base image, and I have fed it with AP keys or tokens, aliases, functions, and setup paths to build a new image called offensive Docker custom. Of course, the new image is private because it contains personal credentials. I don't suggest sharing the custom image. Example, I create a new Dockerfile. Dockerfile has the definitions or instructions to build a Docker image. If you can see the image, I have declared WordPress scan token to scan WordPress sites, Amazon Web Service access token to retrieve information from public S3 buckets if there is a misconfiguration, his file to store the common history, find domain tokens, aliases, and other. Finally, the next step is to build the image, and we have an offensive Docker custom image. Following this process, I have customized the offensive Docker with my personal settings to get better results in my security assessments. VPS full automation. VPS means virtual private server. I didn't only work with the Docker customization by a specific process. If there is anything that I like, is the automation. I don't like to do manual processes or do processes more than twice. I like to run just a command, and that is what this project is all about. In some cases, when we find a big target on bug bounty programs, the recon process can take some hours until finish, and we don't want to have to turn off the computer, so the option is to run a VPS. I work on how to automate the VPS creation and configuration. We just access to the VPS and it is ready to launch the security assessments. The steps to launch a VPS are server creation, server setup, and finally server access. The steps 1 and 2 are launched from just a command, and I have called it full automation. You can see the link to GitHub repository. Full automation. It has two steps. The first is server creation. For this step, I have used Terraform. Terraform is a tool to create infrastructure as code. By Terraform, I can provision infrastructure in some cloud providers, but I have chosen DigitalOcean or Google Cloud Platform. Also, I can pass my personal SSH key to access securely without username and password. But the server is not ready to launch my security assessments because it hasn't the offensive Docker. The second step is server setup. For this step, I have used Ansible. Ansible can configure the server status by playbooks. In the playbooks, I have defined how the server should be. For instance, I install Docker, download GitHub repositories, download offensive Docker image from Docker Hub, and other. Ansible use the SSH key defined in the first step and connect to the server to deploy the playbooks. In Ansible Playbook, the main task is install Docker and download offensive Docker from Docker Hub. Additionally, I have configured fail-to-ban service. It is a service to block non-authorized accesses. After I deploy a server, I have seen non-authorized accesses in the logs with SSH connections. Offensive Docker is a public image from Docker Hub and you can use it. Now, I am going to show the full automation video. First, I initialize Terraform, and then I run Terraform Apply to create and configure the server. For this video, I am using DigitalOcean. I am going to advance the video in some parts. After a few seconds, the server was created, and the next step is configure the server. This option is made by Ansible, and Ansible has many tasks. For instance, update and install package, install Docker, download offensive Docker image. This part is the most important. So I am tuning the shell to the server. And the last step is show the public IP address. With this public IP address, I can access to the server and launch my security assessments. The last step is server access. We use any SSH client to connect to the server. Don't forget to use the SSH key used in the first step. After to follow all that steps, let's start the game. We can launch subdomain discovery, port scanning, search directory, and other to retrieve as much information as possible about our targets. Finally, with the public IP address, I can access to the server with the credential, and inside the server, I can launch the container with offensive Docker. That is all. Demo. Let's go to the demo and show how offensive Docker works. As you can see in the screen, possibly go wrong. Demo time, and in the next demo, I show you different functionalities about offensive Docker. I am going to create a demo session and I am initialize my Terraform backend, and the next command is Terraform apply to create the resource. For us is the VPS. After a minute, the server is created and the server is configure with offensive Docker. That's the most important steps to the automation. In the meantime, I am going to open another Windows to check the offensive Docker locally. I told you in the talk that a good tip is use alias, right? I have created different functions environment to launch the offensive Docker. This is for offensive function. I have another function for HubDevox platform and another function for TryHubMeet platform, right? If you can see in the next functions, I have a history in the same path to store
all command histories launch inside the Docker, right? I don't lose the command history information. And I pass the parameter to mount a local directory inside the container when I launch the container, right? I pass this directory to mount inside the Docker, right? In the next folder. Okay, let me check the full automation. Okay, the server was created, right? The server was created, and now the server is being configured by Ansible, right? Now the fail to ban is being installed. Okay, go to local session. I launch a hack the box function to launch a container called RTV for Reptin Village. I am inside the container. If I list the directories, I can see offensive directory and tools directory. Let me check the offensive directory. Offensive directory has two resource machine, folder machines and my profile VPN, right? Inside the container, I have an alias to launch the VPN, right? If I enter VPN HTTP, the VPN start. If you can see, I am connecting to the HackTheBox VPN inside the container, right? This is my profile to HackTheBox. Now I am opening another pane. I need to access to the same container, right? How I access to the same container? I have another function called access, where I pass the name of the container that I launched. The name was RTV, so now I access with this name, Reptin Village, sorry. I am in the same container where I am connected to HackTheBox platform. Now I am scanning for a specific machine. I am going to do a port scanning for this machine and see what ports are open. Right, we can see two port opens. 21 for FTP server and 80 for HTTP server. Now, are you questioning about how to access to HTTP connection inside the Docker to analyze what website is here, right? We need to graphic a browser to see more comfortable the information, right? The solution that I told is start the proxy inside the container and in my browser I have a Foxy proxy that is a good plugin to use different proxies. I have different proxies configuration or profile for different proxies. And now I am going to launch my HTTP connection to the machine. So I have accessed to the server by my browser using the internal proxy in the container. That is the option that I am using to access to HTTP information or HTTP sites by the container
And the container is connecting to the VPN for HackTheBox, right? You can see the website to analyze this information by this way. Okay, but you configured the proxy in the browser, but also you can configure the proxy in Bursuite. For instance, you can use a Burr proxy in Burr. You can configure the proxy localhost . This is the internal port. Okay, intercept is off. Now I go to open again the site, but the traffic is by proxy in Burr, and Burr is using the proxy in container, right? Using this way, I can connect in the browser using Burr, Burr using container, and container connecting to the VPN on HackTheBox, or I can use another VPN, for instance, TryHackMe, or if you use a specific VPN provider, you can use this way to connect to different traffic, right? That is the option that I can provide to this use case, right? Now let me check the full automation option. The offensive Docker image is being downloading by Ansible using the playbook, and we can check another use case in the local. Okay, I can use another tool like as Deer Search or Deer Buster or another tool to use to search directories, right? Inside the Docker, if you see the tools in tools directories, there are the different categories that I have labeled to the tools, right? We can see for recon, deer search, okay, now using deer search with a basic dictionary, I am fusing the site to search by high directories. If you can see, I can access for a directory that GitHub. Okay, go to the browser, paste the directory, and I can access to this information, right? That is the option that I am providing with Offensive Docker. You have some tools to do different process and try different platforms to improve your skill with cybersecurity. You don't need to install all tools because it is a hard effort. You can lose time install the tools and fix problems or do any troubleshooting by the issue installing a specific version of tool. But using Offensive Docker, you can launch different environments to analyze different targets, right? Let me check the full automation. Now the full automation is finished. The public IP address is shown in the screen. And the next step is access to the server with this IP address. Okay, now I am in the server in the DigitalOcean, right? If I check the image, I can see offensive Docker image. Now I need to launch a container. Okay, I am in the Docker in the VPS, right? Now inside the Docker I can launch AMAS for a specific domain, for instance hackerone.com. And I can search for subdomain for this domain, or I can launch Subfinder or another tool that offensive Docker provide, right? That is the main objective, that you can use offensive Docker locally or in a VPS, and you can launch different tools. I can stop AMAS, and I can launch Finder. And you will see the different domains, right? Now you can start the proxy, right? You can, in your browser, if you do a search about your public IP address assigned by internet service provider, this is my public IP address, but now I am going to configure the proxy. This is the public IP address assigned by DigitalOcean to my VPS. Now if I check again, I am using the public IP address by VPS server, right? With this option we can avoid geographic restriction when we need to access to specific targets. In bug bounty programs there are targets to specific countries or specific traffic from any source, and you can bypass this restriction by using a proxy. This is some options to use offensive Docker, right? So if you don't need more the infrastructure on cloud, you can destroy all resources to don't incur in high cost, because if you have a server turned on, it has a cost. You can destroy all infrastructure with the Terraform destroy, and the server is removed, right? When this option you saw the full automation option and use the server locally accessing or analyzing hack the box matching.
To finish offensive Docker reviews, I don't know if you see the videos from XSSRat. He's a bug bounty hunter, and he did a review of my offensive Docker on YouTube. He called the video "Stop Wasting Your Time Installing Tools and Start Using This Docker Image." Integrity is a bug bounty platform, and it suggested offensive Docker 2 weeks ago. Kitploy and Hacking Night blogs have suggested offensive Docker in different articles. That is a good reward for the project. Thanks for your time. I hope that you had enjoyed the talk and the project. The project is open source and you can contribute to it by pull requests. If you like the project, give it a star for it and subscribe to the new release. If you want to see the slides again, you can see the link to the presentation.